Hey, what's up, guys? This video here is going to be about gun stickers and should we be plastering our vehicles with them? Gun shirts, should we be wearing them out loud and proud? What do you think? Well, this topic came up from me commenting on another video, and a bunch of YouTubers out there started PMing me about this topic, and it was kind of cool. We had a little side conversation going on about this, and let's get into it. So gun stickers, well, what do I think? Well, for me, I don't want to put any of these things on my truck. I don't put any type of gun sticker on my truck. The only sticker that's on there is this. And the only people that understand what that is are the people in the know. I get a lot of people that ask me, what the hell is this? What does this mean? Even a cop came up to me and said, what is that, a special ops unit or something? I don't know why he thought that. But when I explained to him what this meant, he kind of just said, that's stupid. Yeah, whatever. So gun stickers, well, I had plenty of them. You know what, I threw most of them out because they were just sitting around. I probably should have just gave them away, but, you know, SIG, HK, Smith & Wesson, Springfield Armory, Glock, you know, you name it, I had those stickers of all those manufacturers. You know, this is just an example. My favorite 1911 is Wilson Combat. I don't put it on my truck. I'm a member. I don't put it on my truck. I don't want people to know. That's what it is. I don't need to advertise that I'm a gun owner, I may be carrying, I support the NRA, what have you. That's my own personal business. Regarding stickers, I was at the round table at the public range. The round table is a bunch of us guys just hanging out at a table and BSing. We're talking about guns, tactics, crime, situations that happen to other people. You know, we just have a discussion. So we start talking about gun stickers and how it's a bad idea to put, you know, plaster this stuff on our trucks, our cars. And one instance here, I don't know this guy. He had just purchased the Ford Raptor, which is an expensive pickup truck. I also know have another acquaintance that just bought one. Anyways, he plastered his Raptor with a lot of different Glock, you know, stickers, and some of those dumb stickers that I think are idiotic. I don't think you need to place stuff on your stickers like about abysmal, oh bullshit, you know, stuff like that. Warning, I don't dial 911, and it's a picture of a guy holding a gun or something. Piss off a liberal, buy a gun. Like a lot of the pro-gun stickers and sayings, he had a lot of that stuff on his Ford Raptor. So one day he was at the range, not the range, but at the mall. He parked his Raptor way out in the back because, you know, he didn't want anyone to ding it or anything. When he came back out, someone took a key and keyed his truck pretty bad. It was just one slice or one scratch, but it was really deep. That pissed him off. Why? Why did someone do that? Could it have been because he parked in the back? I don't think so. Could it have been his stickers on his truck and his windshield? Possibly. So you piss off someone that doesn't, you know, he also had an NRA sticker. Who knows? People are freaking whacked out there and just, they're not right in the head. They feel that if they do this vandalism, somehow they've done some right. They make themselves feel better. They feel great about themselves, about what they just did. They think they've done a justice to society or themselves. I don't know. Bunch of low lives. Anyways, so, you know, could someone, some freaking lowlife, want to vandalize your vehicle because of these stickers and Glock and all that? Yeah, probably. So, there's this one instance there. Another instance, a situation that happened was with, again, I don't know this person. This guy's pickup truck, he had a Chevy. He had a huge Glock decal on the back of his windshield. It was like, it covered the whole windshield. Well, wherever he was, he parked his truck, okay? He went in somewhere. When he came back out, his windshield was busted in, broken. Uh-oh, what happened? Well, he had three Glocks in the back seat, underneath the back seat, and one Kel-Tec. Now, why on earth did he have these guns just laying in, you know, back there? You know, granted, if he was transporting them, okay, I can see that, but I am extremely uneasy about just leaving an unsecured firearm, even if it's locked up, just leaving it unattended in a car or truck, that really bothers me. I can't do that. But who knows what happened. So someone smashed his windshield and stole his three Glocks. He had a 19, a 32, and a 34, and some Kel-Tec 9mm. All gone. Never got them back. Don't know where they are. But I guess now they're in, you know, somebody's hands. Who knows? You know? Ridiculous. So did that Glock sticker scream out to the a feral being saying, "Oh, I bet that guy's got a gun in there." Yeah. We don't know. Possibly. Most likely. Why pick that truck out of all the other vehicles in this parking lot? So, there's another thing for you. Even though you don't have something in there, someone could still, you know, try to break in. Then you got to deal with insurance and all that. Like the guy with the Ford Raptor. File an insurance claim, pays deductible to repaint the entire side of his truck that was a 1 year old. Or it's not even a year old, I think, they said. It sucks. So yeah, I don't believe in placing gun stickers all over our vehicles. I think it's just a huge, it turns it into a billboard, a target. You know what I mean? You don't want that hassle. You really don't. It's unfortunate that someone may vandalize your car just because you have this on there. Or, you know, some feral being wants to break into your car because he thinks you're going to have guns in there. Let me tell you something else. More recently, I was in a mall parking lot. I was walking by this Cadillac Escalade, this enormous SUV. And I noticed on the driver's side windshield, you know, the window near the lock, where the lock would pop up, there's this little sticker that said, "Protected by Stag Arms." And it had a, you know, AR-type rifle picture on there. So, I'm a newsie. So, I stop and I'm looking at the sticker, "Protected by Stag Arms." Huh. I'll admit, I kind of walked back and looked in the back of this Escalade where the windows were tinted, and sure enough, there's a rifle case back there. Granted, maybe there's nothing in this case, but I know a rifle case when I see one. A hard shell case. Pretty nice case at that. Why? Why do that? Yeah, it's kind of a cool thing, protected by Stag Arms. This vehicle is protected by Smith & Wesson, you know. But you don't need to put that stuff on your vehicles. I mean, it just attracts attention. See, for me being a newsie, you know, I walk by and I see that protected by Stag Arms. I just wanted to kind of look to see what's in the back, you know, just to make a point. Yeah, there's a rifle case in the back. So, I guess I don't think it's a good idea to put stickers on. With shirts, same thing. If you're carrying concealed and this is on you, why attract attention? "Oh, the guy's wearing a gun shirt. Yeah, look at that. I wonder if he's carrying a gun." You know, then you get some of these freaking scumbags that want to mess with you. Who knows? Like, "Hey, what's up?" You know, they think you got a gun. They want to mess with you. I don't know. Anything can happen out there. Why don't you just blend in with the crowd and be the gray man? Meaning, just blend in with the population where you don't stand out. That's the goal. You don't stand out. But I will admit, the few times I wore this shirt out, it's gotten a lot of attention. One time, I went to the gun shop with this on, and there was a girl that working behind the counter. Of all people, it was funny. The girl was like, hey, she said, "I watched Pete too." It was kind of funny. And another guy in the gun shop said the same thing. "I watched the Armory Channel." And I was at the mall once, and I got stopped by a random guy. He said, "I watch him too." So, it attracts attention. This attracts attention, guys. This shirt here did also. Some weird guy was just like, "Yo, what's up with that, man?" I'm like, it's just like, okay, you know, you don't have to point at me and make a spectacle of everything. "Yo, he's strapped." That's what he was saying. I was like, what the hell? So this stuff kind of, you know, attracts attention, and I'd rather not have that attention. I do have HK shirt, you know. It's a cool shirt, but I'm not going to wear it out and bring it down. I have a Nighthawk Custom polo. I guess I could wear that. It doesn't really look like a gun shirt, but still, if I'm carrying, which is, you know, majority of the time, I'd rather not have people pointing at me and, "Hey, you're strapped," or, you know what I mean? I don't want anyone to know about this. So, guys, leave some comments, and if you have any experiences, if you've ever worn a gun shirt out, or do you have these gun stickers on your vehicle? Has anything ever happened? What do you think about this? I'd be very curious. So, as always, guys, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.